computers represent data in binary. So every number that a computer wants to work with needs to be stored as just a sequence of zeros and ones. For non-negative integer values, the interpretation looks a lot like how we represent numbers in decimal. Each bit, that is, each 0 or 1, represents a different power of 2. We have a bit for representing 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, and so on. Adding up the place values for each bit with a value of 1 gives us the number that's represented. But computers often need to represent numbers that aren't integers. That is, numbers that have some fractional part to them as well. Nowadays, most computers follow a common, standardized way of representing these numbers, but it wasn't always that way. There are multiple ways we could have tried to represent fractional parts of numbers. One option is what's known as a fixed point representation, where we store a fixed number of digits in the fractional part of the number. In decimal, for example, we could represent numbers by storing 4 digits before the decimal and 4 digits after the decimal. In binary, we can do the same thing. We could store 4 bits for the integer part and 4 bits for the fractional part. Ignoring negative numbers for now, the integer bits would still represent 1, 2, 4, and 8. And then the fractional bits would represent 1 half, 1 quarter, 1 eighth, and 1 16th. Using this representation, some numbers are easily representable, like 1.5 or 4.75. But some numbers, like 2.8, can't be represented precisely by these bits. There's no combination of these four fractions that's equivalent to 0.8, so the best a computer can do is to settle for some representation that's as close as it can get to 2.8, but it won't be perfectly precise. This is a problem no matter what format we choose for representing real numbers, because there are infinitely many real numbers, but we're only allowing ourselves a finite fixed number of bits to represent them. One problem you might notice with this fixed point approach to representing numbers is that the numbers we can represent can no longer get as big. When we allocated all the bits to integer places, we could represent much larger numbers. But with some of the bits allocated to fractional places, we lose that dynamic range. A solution to this, and the solution that modern computers have standardized on, is the floating point number. Instead of storing an integer part and a fractional part, a floating point number has a mantissa and an exponent. You might be familiar with this approach in decimal with scientific notation. The number 128 can be represented as 1.28 times 10 to the second power. The number 0.0042 can be represented as 4.2 times 10 to the negative third power. Each representation has an exponent, and it has a mantissa, also called a significand, that's some number that's at least 1 but less than 10, that's then multiplied by 10 raised to the exponent. In binary, we can do much the same thing. Our mantissa will always take the form of 1 point something, because it's at least 1 but needs to be less than 2. The exponent we can also represent in binary as some integer. To interpret the number, we take the mantissa and multiply it by 2 raised to the exponent. The advantage here is that with a fixed number of bits for the mantissa and a fixed number of bits for the exponent, we can represent a wider range of numbers in this floating point representation than we could with a fixed point representation. That advantage isn't free. It comes at the cost of less precision in the fractional part as the numbers get more extreme. But usually, that's a reasonable trade-off to make. So how then do computers actually store floating-point numbers? The format is standardized by the Institute of Electrical and Electronics Engineers, or IEEE. In their IEEE 754 standard, they provide a number of different formats for floating-point numbers, but two of the most common are called single precision and double precision. The single precision format uses 32 bits to represent a number, while the double precision format uses 64 bits and can therefore represent a wider range of values more precisely. Let's look at single precision numbers first. The 32 bits start with 1 bit for the sign of the number, 0 means a positive number, 1 means a negative number. Then comes 8 bits for the exponent, followed by 23 bits for the mantissa. Let's take a closer look at the exponent. We're using 8 bits to store its value, which can represent numbers from 0 up to 255. But we don't just want to represent positive exponents. We also need to represent negative exponents. So we need to shift this range of possible values to allow negative exponents too. How will we do that? Well, let's take the number at the middle of this range, 127, and let that represent an exponent of 0. Numbers bigger than 127 represent positive exponents. Numbers less than 127 represent negative exponents. So whatever exponent value we've stored, we'll subtract 127, and that will give us the actual exponent we should use, positive or negative. Now let's look at the mantissa. Each bit of the mantissa represents some fractional place, 1, 1 half, 1 quarter, 1 eighth, and so on. That lets us represent values that are at least 1 and less than 2. But since all of these numbers start with a 1, we don't actually need to store the 1. We can just store the fractional places after the initial 1 and assume there's a 1 at the start. This means that even though we're using 23 bits to store the mantissa, we can actually represent the mantissa with 24 bits of precision. And that's the essential idea. Now, if we have a floating point representation of a number, we can take the mantissa, add on that initial 1, and figure out what number that represents. Then we can take the exponent, subtract 127, and figure out what the actual exponent should be. Then we take the mantissa, multiply it by 2 raised to the exponent, and use the sign bit to determine if the answer is positive or negative. There are a few additional parts of the standard that are worth noting. One thing you might have noticed is that if the mantissa is always between 1 and 2, we don't have a good way to represent 0. There are other values we might care about representing too. We might want to represent infinity if you perform calculations where the numbers get too big, or represent an invalid number if you do something like divide 0 by 0 or take the square root of a negative number. The floating point format as we've described it can't handle that yet. To do so, let's go back to the exponent. Remember, we're using 8 bits to represent it, and then subtracting 127, so that values from 0 to 255 represent actual exponents of negative 127 to 128. The IEEE standard special cases the two values at the extreme ends, 0 and 255, to mean something special. So as a result, normal floating point values can only represent actual exponents between negative 126 and 127. So what do we do with these extreme exponents? If the exponent is 0 and the mantissa is 0, that represents the number 0. If the exponent is the maximum 255 and the mantissa is 0, that represents either infinity or negative infinity, depending on the sign bit. If the exponent is 0 and the mantissa is not 0, that can be used to represent what are called subnormal numbers, which are numbers that are so close to 0 that they can't be represented using our normal mantissa and exponent format. And if the exponent is the maximum 255 and the mantissa is not 0, that represents something that's not a number. The format is very similar for double precision numbers, commonly just called doubles. We just get more bits to use for the mantissa and the exponent. The mantissa, instead of being 23 bits, is now 52 bits. And the exponent, instead of being 8 bits, is now 11 bits. More bits for the exponent means we can represent much bigger and much smaller numbers. And more bits for the mantissa means we can get more precise representations of those numbers. So that's how computers store floating point numbers. We have a sign bit to determine if the number is positive or negative, an exponent that tells us how big or small the number is, and a mantissa that lets us specify a number's value up to a particular precision.